and scratch each other up with their teeth. So we look at their eyes each and every morning to see if they have any deep cuts that we need to look at. So similar to us, if you have a deeper cut, we might want to treat it with some kind of antibiotic so that way it doesn't get infected. Same thing with our dolphins. So they are able to salt water, which is excellent for taking care of those wounds. Their skin sheds about once every 2 hours, so they're always constantly replacing those skin cells. Another way that you see us caring for our dolphins, I mentioned they grab and swallow their fish whole, but they live in all this water, but they can't drink any of the water that they're actually living in. So since they're mammals, they do need fresh water, just like us, so drinking salt water will make them dehydrated, and we give them an upset stomach. So you see our trainers, they have some fun looking things that they're sticking in our dolphin's mouth, and there's little syringes, especially as dolphin straws in the end of them. So all our dolphins are trained to take a little bit extra water voluntarily, so we can give them a little bit extra hydration. So just like getting lots of water for us is good for our bodies, same thing for our dolphins. So we give them lots and lots of water. Here's Maya. She did a chance to say hello to you guys earlier. There's Maya right there, swimming in the sunlight. You can see she's a much lighter coloration than some of our dolphins that we have up front here. So looking over our dolphin's eyes and giving them this water is an excellent way that we can help provide care for our dolphins. So we look over their eyes and ask them to present the different parts of their eyes. We check their backs, their stomachs, even their tails, or look inside their mouth. So when we're in this position, giving them that water, we can look over their teeth. Do they have any teeth that might have gotten chipped by accident? Are their tongues okay? They do eat fish that have spines on them, so sometimes they get little scratches in their throat when they're eating their fish. So those are all things that we can check out on the dolphins. We can train them to kind of give us different samples so our dolphins participate in everything that they do. So they have a choice in everything. So we have a hall up right here, so that's how all the ways that we can get weights on our dolphins. So we can hold them up on the deck to get their weight on them to make sure they're nice and healthy. So in addition to that weight, we need to give them exercise as well, and along with a balanced diet. So here you see another example of that calling out weight behavior right over there. So those are all different ways that we can ask them for different things. We can also ask for their tail. We can collect blood samples from them. So we can work with our vets and work with our dolphins so that way we can get different parts of their bodies so we can make sure they're nice and clean by testing different samples. We can ask for chalk from our dolphins. So that's just kind of when the dolphin offers speed. So that's another sample that we can get. So if you look over here on the right hand side, and in the middle here, you can see some of the layouts that we put our dolphins in to ask for different blood samples from them. So they present us with their tail in their native area, and once again, they have the choice to turn on this at any point in time if they feel uncomfortable, nervous, scared, anything like that. So just like us, some people like chats, some people really don't. So same thing with dolphins. Some may be a little bit more scared than others. So last but not least, we have to do lots of exercise and lots of learning with our dolphins to keep them both mentally and physically stimulated. So we're going to start off with some speed. Bailey's going to show you her speed coming around. So dolphins can swim up to 25 miles an hour. And they're pumping their tails up and down. Versus sharks and fish kind of move their tails side to side. Dolphins are mammals and they pump their tails up and down. So their tail provides them with all the power to pull themselves through the water, jump up out of the water, or even splash water around as well. So that speed is really important. I mentioned they do shed their skin about once every 2 hours. They don't have any external ears. And they have all sorts of fins for different purposes. So their tails are back. Their growth will make them nice and stable and keep them from spiraling out of control. And their pectoral fins to the side are used a lot in steering. Now we're going to see an example of a slower moving dolphin. So dolphins can move about, typically on average, they swim about 3 to 5 miles an hour when they're just at a normal kind of pace. But you can also see a little bit of her mouth right there as well. And you can also take note of the shape of the dorsal fin. So all of our dolphins have different shaped dorsal fins, and along with all the different unique markings and characteristics. So now here's another way we can get our dolphins some exercise. Over there on the left hand side, we're going to start doing some handles with our dolphins. So this is important when they're learning different behaviors, especially from their moms. So when they're growing up, they depend on mom to teach them how to socialize with other dolphins, how to play, socialize, how to play, all those things they watch mom for. So you see we're jumping up and down, so saving their tail and our feet. And now we're going to see another. There we have another behavior from our dolphin here. Bailey right there showing you her vertical spin. This is a great way that dolphins can stretch and just move their arms. And this is another fun place to do your own Myers showing you. So this is a back dive. Once again, they have a really strong, powerful tail in there just to kind of get themselves out of the water. So there they are showing all the pectoral fins there on the side. So dolphins struggle with the water for lots of different reasons. So we mentioned they scratch edges, they can breathe, they can just have a lot of life, or they can communicate with one another. We're seeing another part of the spin right there. And Bailey's going to show you. There's our smallest little dolphin showing you. She can fall in the water. And we walk out towards the center here, Jane, showing you another walking here. So that's a back reach. The dolphin can jump out of the water, land on groups of fish and stun them. Also communicate with dolphins that might be further away. And if you turn your eyes towards the center, here's another fun playful behavior. Maybe she decides to do it there. We're going to show you their pattern on their tail once more. So for you in the front four rows, you're going to get an excellent view of this arc.
We're going to get wet. Okay.
Yeah.